Holly, could you give an update on the kids that were out that might be back on Sunday?
It's just kind of still a day to day. We just got a lot of bumps and bruises, and I know for certain that Jamie won't be. She still has her cast on, but other than that, I think it's just kind of a trial and just day to day thing.
What's the update on Moore? Did you learn more about what she's dealing with?
I don't know the medical term, but she does have some pulled things in her ribs, and it's just difficult. It's just sore. I mean, it's, you know, and I said earlier, for Nia Moore to be hurting and her to be emotional about it, that she's hurting, because she's a tough kid. So we're just going to take that day to day, and she was at practice yesterday, and she'll be here today. So,
but she's not
didn't get on the floor.
The indication was that all along with that you thought Diamond would be ready by the start of the year, but
yeah.
She's still a little, it's still iffy. Has there been a setback, or has there been?
I don't think it's a setback. I just think it's we've just taken it and day to day, and kind of see what her, you know, she knows her body, and so we go off of what she's telling us, and it's just kind of a day-to-day thing, Dan.
Is she still, like, sore a little after practice?
Yeah,
then?
Yeah. And I just, it's, you know, I just think it's just, plus just getting back and playing. She's been out a year. I think just the up and down, pounding, that kind of stuff, I'm sure that's kind of, you know, feels different as well.
Any concerns that it could be an extended thing, or are you thinking it's still?
I don't anticipate it being extended, but I just got to go with players that are there.
And with Cooper, same deal. It's just kind of day to day.
Yeah.
You have an idea who you'll start on
Sunday?
I
don't know who's going to be healthy. You know, I think that you know, we've got a solid group and team. We start on Sunday. May not be the team we start at Stanford. I just think it's a day-to-day thing for us, and I think everybody will be ready, and we'll just go with who's available.
Did it help? How much was it even more helpful than usual to have an exhibition game this year because of
absolutely.
The uncertainty with?
Well, I think with Mimi getting in as a freshman, and then Courtney's role getting a little bit more minutes at that stage, and it's always good for us to play well, to play together. And you know, we're having great practices, but it's just a matter of getting out and getting in front of people and how we're going to react and how we're going to respond. So that's why we do it, and I will always continue to do it, because I like it. We can work on things, we can see things, and it's a great teaching tool for us, especially with officials there in the crowd.
Anything that stuck out watching the game on film that maybe you haven't noticed immediately after the game, or?
No, I mean there's so many areas that we can get better. I thought the first quarter we got winded because we had to go that long period of time. I think we're in shape. I just think we got to push through some things. I saw that we in the fourth quarter we could press even then, though we've been through a long game. So I just want to make sure that my biggest thing is playing hard. And I thought for the most part we played hard. We didn't get in the right spot all the time. We didn't do the right things, but I thought the overall game, I thought we had some very good effort. So, and that's something to build on, and that's what we're going to try to continue to do.
In the exhibition game, you shot 60% from the field and 80% from the free throw line. Are those numbers that you can be happy with as a coach?
Oh my gosh, I love it. I love those numbers. 60%, I'll take that any. I don't care who you're playing. That's you're taking for the most part very good shots. And happy to see, especially Mercedes shot well from the free throw line. So, yeah, we'll take those numbers.
With this group, how are you going about establishing roles and with various people? Do you have to talk more with them, or not?
Well, I think we just got through and hadn't met with everybody, but met with a lot of our players. Talked about roles. Talked about what we, you know, thing about this team, Dan, is that we don't. we don't have to do, these kids don't have to do something they're not, that's not their strength. I want them to go to their strength. I want Courtney Dunbar, if she's open at the three-point line, take the shot. I want Mercedes Russell to spend a lot of her time down on the block. You know, I want the ball in Jordan and Taya's hands 99% of the time, because they're great ball handlers and they can lead a team. So that's when we set goals, just kind of stay with your strengths, because we got all the talent we have on the team can cover all bases of the game. So I'm not asking anybody to do something they're not good at.
This game, Central Arkansas, so how did you end up scheduling? Is this a Michael Beaumont production?
No question. It's Coach Beaumont is from that area, and he wanted somebody other than University of Arkansas to come to Knoxville. And so,
is that serious?
Yes.
It is? Okay.
Yes, it's serious. I have no ties to Central Arkansas, but Michael apparently does. He runs the show.
How many of y'all are doing that scheduling? How carefully do you look at some of those low-major, mid-major teams, kind of where they might be picked to finish in terms of that conference, just in terms of RPI and stuff?
Well, sure.
Like,
I mean, you look at who we're playing. You take Penn State. They've been in the tournament. You take Syracuse. They've been in the tournament. Albany won their conference. They were in the tournament. Wichita State won their conference. They're in the tournament. You see Stanford, you see Oregon State. So everybody outside the SEC, I think we've got one of the toughest schedules we've had in a very, very long time. And it is by design. I always say that we try to play teams that are not like the SEC, and maybe they spread the floor. Maybe they're five guards that have a lot of quickness. And in Central Arkansas, a little bit like Carson Newman, spread the floor, shoots the three, drives. So those are teams that we have sometimes difficult with. So try to schedule teams that we may not usually see in the SEC, but I think our schedule is pretty tough.
So there, what kind of challenges do these guys present you?
Well, they lost a lot of starters, but you see tendencies. I think they shoot the three, they'll penetrate, they move the ball. I mean, they're scrappy kids, and are we bigger? Yes. And sometimes that isn't, you know, they'll pull our posts outside away from the paint. It's just a different team. It's just a different style, and one that we don't see quite often. So it'll be a challenge for us. It'll be a challenge for us on Sunday.
Of these nine games you're playing at home here before, how many of these are you going to have to return a game for? You going back to Syracuse next year?
We're going back to Penn State, I believe. We're going back to, obviously, Stanford. Not quite sure about Oregon State.
These other home games early, you're not returning, like Syracuse, you're not going to Syracuse?
No, Syracuse wanted to come down here. They asked to come down here. So,
so Penn State's the only one you're...
Penn State, Texas, we'll still have a series with Texas, so...
Coach, you limited Carson Newman to two fast break points. How do you kind of prepare your team to defend the fast break?
Well, we preach it. We work on it every day. And we're not quite there yet, really. But we try to simplify. I thought at the beginning of this year, we our transition defense was a little complicated. It was a little confusing. And so a couple of weeks out, we tried to simplify it. And I think that's a positive for us. For Carson Newman to only give up, you know, transition is huge, especially in the SEC. And it seems that when we've struggled to beat teams, they've had great transition offense. So that's been a focal point for us. And I think it's gotten better. Now we'll see as the season progresses, but it has been a major focal point for us. So hopefully that's why it's gotten better.
With the injured players other than Jamie, is it kind of maybe like a game time decision, see how they feel Sunday, or will you have to decide before then? Or
I'd much rather them get experience on the practice floor. I don't like to play kids when they've been out and they get better right at game time. And so I want them to get in practice, just to get the flow, to understand what we're doing, our game plan. So yeah, it is day to day. Will it? It could happen, but I really want some kids to get in practice and put in the time and get have the preparation to get ready to play our opponent.